Okay. All right. I'm gonna get started here with this live tutorial. Yes, indeed. We'll go ahead and get started. Hello. Hi, guys. Happy Sunday. Hope you guys are having a wonderful Sunday summer break. The weather's been good to you. It was really, really, really muggy today, and that's really rare for the Southwest. But it's all good. It's probably better to have a little muggy than dry. So right off the bat, this is where I'm at with the Jon Snow painting, the oil painting. That I've been working on for the past, I guess I could say for the past week and a half. It's taking a little longer to do this one versus the Daenerys painting that I was working on. And that was because, it's a lot of, I've been very, very busy with other activities and stuff with the kids for the summer, you know, all my kids are out. So this is where I'm at with the Jon Snow painting from Jon Snow from Game of Thrones. I've actually gotten to a lot of the glazing. I did really approach a lot of his coat, his garment. The frizzy kind of coat that he has going on that he wears when he is the he's like the headmaster over at the wall. And that was about like a season and a half ago. And but this is like one of my favorite pictures of Jon Snow's character. So this particular technique of approaching his coat, the objective is for it to be tactile. Can you guys see that okay? For the garment to be as tactile as possible, meaning that you really want this coat to be 3D, coming like off of the surface, off of the canvas. And just to kind of come out and grab you, tactile. So with this particular technique, you know, this in painting his garment, there are some layers involved, and just making those paintbrush strokes very poignant, and it just poignant and 3D, that's your objective. And so you're just going to use, right now I'm using titanium white just to really increase this image to become more 3D looking. And to do that, you really have to kind of, your palette is like, your palette is a 3D palette. Your 3D is a chiaroscuro contrast effect. So.
Adam, where's your dad?
I'll be there in just a few minutes. Okay, so. Yeah, it's just like that chiaroscuro effect that you want going on. And you know what? Those who paint, people who are artists, if you know the term chiaroscuro is an Italian Renaissance term that was used imply during the Italian Renaissance paintings of the very low contrast, very high contrast. So that is what that is. Okay, and so, yeah. So yeah, the whole thing with the chiaroscuro effect, it really just makes that image very 3D as possible, jumping out at you. With the coat. Now, let's talk a little bit more about the face today.
Yeah.
Let's kind of talk more about the face here going on here. What I've done. I'm happy where the stage of the flesh tone is with his complexion. As of right now, I may actually add a little bit more on to his complexion here. We have all of this bit here though. His coat really kind of goes more in here. Like I said, I don't even know if you see this. There's a lot of like blending here that I'm using. By the way, the brushes that I'm using today is like this little blending brush here, if you can see that. This blending brush here has kind of a nice blending. It's not firm. It's a very soft blending brush. Nothing really significant or poignant, but it just helps me blend my smaller areas together. And this one is like a pointy filbert tip to it. So that kind of really helps to get that area. So I'm not, delving in. We can talk about, going back to the complexion, I'm really happy to where his complexion is at this point. I'm actually probably going to add a little bit more of some flesh tint white, just to really bring out more of the ivoriness in his complexion. Right now it's has a lot of yellow tones in it. But yeah. And just to kind of really bring that out. So, and I'm gonna get there in just a minute. For right now, the next couple of minutes, I'm just going to be doing, just kind of working in the brush strokes into the coat. Now, those who are tuning in, I want to take this time to look and see who's tuning in right now. Should be, let's see here. I'm going to be posting this video up. I'm going to save this video and post it up on my Instagram. And I actually I'm relaunching my art channel on YouTube. I had actually initially launched it a month ago, but there were some things that I had to take care of marketing wise and presentation and all of that. And there's some advertising and marketing, art presentation that I had to take care of the site before, so it can just really come out in style. So I had to push a pause button on it for about a month or two. And but as of this week, I'm going to be relaunching it, and I'm going to be uploading. I will be uploading the videos that I have, some of the videos that I have recorded here on Instagram, and also live videos that I have recorded on my Facebook page. I will be uploading those to my YouTube channel, so you guys can see them whenever you want. there's some live tutorials I have done on my Facebook page that are always there for you to see. But I will be also, like I said, uploading those to my YouTube channel. it's about building up this jacket for right now. It's the tactileness. I mean, I don't have to get too much into it, you know, making it all too tactile. But, these squiggly lines here. It's gonna probably take some, probably a couple more days to finish this coat. But I don't have to worry about it. So, but what I want to get into is the really neat stuff here. So, that's, I mean, coats fabric is interesting to paint and whatnot. But I mean, my favorite parts of the paint is our faces. I love faces. I love features. And so that's what I'm going to be doing the next couple of months. You know what? I need to clean these brushes. I have got to clean these brushes today. I usually don't clean my brushes too well. Okay, so, all right. So as you can see, there's a nice glazing here on the forehead. I'm just going to be putting some highlights in to Jon Snow. And you know, those who are of you who are Game of Thrones fans, from the Game of Thrones pages here on Instagram, this is a good time to talk about this. I'm going to be posting a video soon, probably maybe this week. Hopefully this week, I will be posting a video of how I watched Game of Thrones without having to pay HBO for it. And I think those of you who know about that whole ordeal, you guys who are big fans of Game of Thrones, but you don't have an HBO on an annual basis. I mean, you're not paying for it. You don't have paid cable or whatever the case may be. And I can talk a little bit about that now, of how my husband and I, we do that. And I'm the one that actually has to have the reins have to be held on me for that, because, you know, as soon as Game of Thrones season comes around, I'm very, 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 very anxious. It's been like a whole entire 365 days, like, that we've had to have to wait for the first episode to come on. And finally, when it comes, I'm like, I gotta see it, because I don't want to miss out. I just don't want to be, I don't want to lag and be late on the reviews and the video reviews and the video critiques that come up on the next day after the show comes on YouTube. A lot of people, you guys have, like, you know, you have YouTube channels where you review films and shows that are your favorite, and a few of those are Game of Thrones. And so I really wanted to take part of that and have my own review show this season for Game of Thrones, and I will do that. And one of those ways, so I think it's going to be this week. So we have not, usually in the past, we've added our Game of Thrones freebie for the 1 month free from HBO Go. We've done that every single year. My husband, his philosophy is, like, the best way to do it is you wait until the next to the last episode is on, has aired, and then you go into HBO Go and get the free month and watch all of the Game of Thrones episodes in like 1 week. That's the secret, guys. That is the secret. And I mean, maybe that's the way some of you guys are already doing that anyway, but that's the way that we're going to be doing it. And we're, since it's only 7 episodes this week, this season, that's why we're going to approach it. And so I'm sorry, I just got off of a rabbit trail and was talking to you. So it's only appropriate to talk about that since we're painting a Game of Thrones character. If you want to know more about my techniques and the way that I paint figurative painting wise, my school of painting of people who I actually painters of the past or even like presently that I really look up to, or please comment, ask me, drop a question. My official website for my artist website is up on zinkia.com. You can go visit that with a lot of my earlier works. You can also check me over at Facebook, or just here. Just please just write me a message, a comment. I will be putting up another progression video or a photo midweek to show you how this painting is going. And I hope you guys have a wonderful Sunday, a wonderful afternoon. Any questions or comments, please let me know. Please follow me. also the same over at Facebook. And like I said, I will be getting that, my YouTube channel, my art channel will be coming up this week as well. So have a great afternoon, a great weekend, and be blessed. Thanks. Bye.